What a week from the White House to the courthouse. Watching Donald Trump sitting in the courthouse was absolutely surreal. I mean, how can you go from being the president of the United States, sitting in the Oval Office, the White House, to sitting in a courthouse? I mean, yeah, I know some of you guys are convinced that it's unjust, and I do think it's unjust, for sure. And some of you are convinced that it might actually help him politically. Maybe in a primary, but definitely not in a general election. I don't think so. Let's look at the whole situation. The whole thing is supposed to be a falsifying records. They're claiming that he falsified records. It's a 2-year statute of limitation charge. That means you have 2 years to really charge, or else you can no longer really charge. Well, it was initially a misdemeanor, but this state prosecutor made it a state case, but he made it a felony by saying that it was in violation. It was used to violate another law, a campaign finance law or something like that. The whole thing is really shaky. It doesn't make a lot of sense as far as I don't think it's gonna stick. Either way, I think it does its damage. It just reminds people that dealing with Trump, you're dealing with a whole lot of baggage, a lot of drama, whether it's fear or not. I think that's the whole purpose of the whole prosecution. I don't think it has anything to do with justice whatsoever. I think it's pretty transparent with people. But I think it's still going to be effective in helping the Democrats, because it's just going to remind people that Trump brings a bunch of drama, a bunch of baggage to the situation. Again, do I think it's just what they did? Absolutely not. That's the type of country we live in now. This is the type of thing that we used to make fun of other countries for. At least some of us used to make fun of other countries for this type of behavior. Oh, jailing your political opposition, the guy who's going to be running against you. It looks really bad. You have a Democrat, a liberal prosecutor targeting a former president of the United States who's planning on running for president again in 2024. Yeah, it looks really bad. If you're gonna prosecute somebody like that, you better have a really good reason. And clearly they don't. It looks completely political. But the good news is it exposes this country for what it really is. It shows what we've really become. So anybody who has any delusions about what this country is at this point, it's being stripped away. We are looking absolutely ridiculous, and people are seeing us for who we truly are, unfortunately. Empire in decline. I hate to see this happen to this country, but that's just the reality. Okay, the banking, the financial crisis, that's not over with. Just because you're not seeing a lot of that in the news doesn't mean it's over. In fact, there's a news concern, the non-banks, the hedge funds, the insurers, all these entities that lend out money but are not technically banks. The problem is the interest rates. The interest rates are going up and up and up. And they are going up because the Federal Reserve is responding to an increase in inflation. So with these interest rates going up, certain people are going to have more difficulty acquiring credit, more difficulty acquiring these funds. And that's going to have an impact on various businesses. It's going to create a domino effect, a ripple effect. And the whole financial situation, that crisis, it's not going to stop with just Silicon Valley Bank. It's not going to stop with Signature Bank. We're going to have more problems. So it's something we have to be aware of. Make sure you have some cash on hand, something I got to deal with. You know, moving from Kentucky to Georgia was really expensive. I had a relocation package that had some money, so that really helped. But man, it's still really, really expensive. You know, you get to a place and it's like $660 for the move-in fee and the deposit. And then you're paying $1,200, $1,300, $1,400 for rent. I think I was paying like $525 back in Kentucky. Now I'm paying a lot more. Rent is expensive all over the place. You can't find anything for $900 in this area, and I'm far away from Atlanta. It's definitely a challenge. And you gotta pay the deposit for the utilities and things like that. So things get really expensive when you move. So it's just something I really don't want to hit the fan now, because it's just a really bad time for that to happen for me. But you know, bad things happen whether you are prepared for them or not. I just prepare the best that I can. But yeah, today, well, this week was my first week at work. A lot of challenges, being you know, the boss, so to speak. There's some directives. I'm not gonna get into that too much, but it's definitely a new experience, working with people in a different way. And I will say that I have made some progress. So as challenging as it may be, it's been some progress, and I just have to remain consistent. So I'm looking forward to that. I think we've turned a corner. We're gonna see some good things happen. I know I'm being vague about this job I have, but I mostly work with people. So, all right. So your thoughts about Trump being in a courthouse, do you think this is gonna help him politically? Do you think it's gonna help him with the primary against DeSantis? I know he had a bump in the polls, but you know, at one point Romney was leading Obama in the polls, in the general election polls. I mean, those polls don't really mean anything to me. Republicans were supposed to do a lot better in 2022. Obviously, they did what they do best, and that's lose. Okay, they barely took over the House, which was really pathetic. But you guys share your thoughts on Trump. Does this change the way you view this guy? Do you think it's going to change the way that people view him, or you think it's going to put, or you think it's going to highlight the? It may help him in that it may force him to run like he did in 2016 when he actually won, run as this outsider. He can say that, hey, the system is against me, the system is against you. I'm running to actually drain the swamp. The problem with that is he was already president of the United States and he didn't drain the swamp. He actually hired a bunch of people who were completely incompetent. Not all of them. He actually had some pretty good Supreme Court nominations. I will give him that. And we've seen some pro-Second Amendment things since, so that's been great. But he surrounded himself with the worst people, which is really weird because he had a TV show where they focus on hiring and firing people for a particular management job. So for somebody like that to be on this show for 10 years and then in a real life situation where he's got to find some quality people and surround himself with the worst people is really bizarre. But anyway, speaking of the Second Amendment, Florida finally went through and said, hey, we're going to have constitutional carry. So that's absolutely great. I think we now have, what, at least 26 states in the union that actually allow people to exercise their Second Amendment right without having to get a permit. So you don't need permission in those 26 states. I'm in one of those states right now. It really helped my move to Georgia because I don't want to have to move to another state. And you have that period of time where you can't carry a gun because you don't have a permit that's recognized in that state. And once you move from one state to another, you're no longer a resident of the old state, so you don't have a permit that's recognized by the new state. And anyway, constitutional carry makes it a lot easier to move from one state to another. So if I wanted to move to Florida, for example, or move to Texas, it'll make it a lot easier. So something to keep in mind. Oh, speaking of which, are you planning any type of big moves anytime soon? And are you considering moving down to Florida or Texas or anything like that? A lot of you guys said that I would be great. I would enjoy Texas. So share your thoughts. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. And don't forget the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.